I am going to show you two demos using secrets. One demo will just be my very simple example app. And in another demo, I'm going to show you how to set up a WordPress using secrets as environment variables. Let's first start with the first one, secrets as volumes. I first need to set up the secrets. In my deployment, I have hello world secrets.yaml. This hello world secrets has the username and the password. Kubectl create of this file deployment hello world secrets.yaml. And then I have another deployment. I have a hello world with secrets as volumes. Three replicas of this one, one container, a volume mount, and this is the volume with the secret name DB secrets, the one I just created in Kubernetes. And this will be mounted under etcsecrets. Kubectl create again. And then let me just get the pods. All of them are running. Let me describe one of them. Describe pod. And what I want to show you first is what I mentioned in the beginning, that Kubernetes itself also uses the secrets in volumes to share the Kubernetes credentials. And that you can see here, volume mounts, we already have a volume, var run secrets Kubernetes service account from default token. This is a volume that is already mounted and is done by Kubernetes itself to share the secrets within the pod so the pod can access the API. And then we have the etcsecrets, the one that we created from the cred volume. So let's start a shell, kubectl execute the pod name. We're going to execute something on the pod. I'm going to add some flags to enable standard input that we can actually type in some commands. And then we're going to execute /bin/bash, which is a shell. And this just gives us a shell on one of the pods. If we then take a look at what's in etcsecrets username, then you see root is in username and password is in password. So our credentials are available in this etcsecrets, and your application just has to read those files, and then those values, the data in those files, can be used, for instance, to connect to a database. And that's exactly what I'm going to show you in the next demo. I'm going to show you how to use credentials to spin up a database and WordPress. If you enter mount, then you can also see all the mount points. And here are the two volumes that are mounted. So this one is the default one. If you can have a look at it, it has a token and a certificate that can be used then to access the API. Exit if you want to exit from a shell. And then you're ready for the next demo.